Hello, my loves. Welcome to Lesego'Story. Thank you so much for stopping by to spend your time with me. Welcome and happy 2024. I haven't seen you this year, just like last year. Happy New Year. So as you have seen from the topic of this video, I'm going to be talking about getting off the pill, getting off contraceptives, getting off the patch, IUD, whatever you may have that you are using as birth control. So this is a topic that I've been trying to research for the past 20 years, but I don't know why I just couldn't get the right information. I'm just getting information now when I'm about to turn 45. I just wish that I knew this information in my 20s so that I could, you know, limit some of the issues that maybe I'm having reproductive wise if I knew this information. So I did a little bit of research. I'll be looking down because I have some notes that I've written down here so that I do not forget anything, because this is a very, very packed topic. Getting off birth control and going the natural route and being able to track your cycle, being able to know your body. And by the way, one thing that I've realized is that one thing that I found out actually while I was doing this research is a woman can get pregnant only 5, 6, 7 days in the month. So it's not like you can get pregnant the whole month. There's only a week whereby you should be able to maybe protect yourself if you didn't want to get pregnant. Okay. So what I have learned is that we have 28 days in our cycle, right? I'm sure everybody knows that. But there is a certain time whereby before ovulation, whereby you are free, you can do whatever you want, but 7 days later, you have your ovulation cycle. That is when you should be able to protect yourself. So what I've learned is that the business of birth control, it's a documentary by Ricky Lake. I don't know if anyone remembers Ricky Lake, but people my age might remember Ricky Lake because we used to watch her show like when we were teenagers. So Ricky Lake, she's in her 50s now, and she did this documentary called The Business of Birth Control, and how you can get off birth control, how you can wean yourself off birth control and make informed choices, you know, make decisions knowing why you're making those decisions. And by the way, these pills, these contraceptives, do you ever get a leaflet, maybe a leaflet that tells you the indications of the medication, of this concoction that you are taking, as in a pill, an injection? Do you know what it really causes, excuse me, in your body? Most of us do not know, because here in South Africa, let me just tell you my story. I started with contraceptives when I was 17, 18 years old. And just mind you, my ovaries, my reproductive system at that time is only 17 years old. Okay. And or 18 years old. And I'm pumping this pills, this injection in my body so that I do not get pregnant. That's one thing that I care about. Do not get pregnant. But I don't know what this is that I'm putting inside my body. So I used to get injections, Neostrate, I think that's what it's called. And you get it every 3 months. Sometimes you don't get your period. Sometimes you get a brown discharge. And I was fine with that because my number one priority was not to get pregnant. I'm sorry, guys. I'm in a very loud place and it's raining as well. So I hope it doesn't disturb you. I'm back. And by the way, these contraceptives can cause women to think of suicide. They can cause weight gain. They can cause water retention. They can cause pulmonary embolism. I'm sure you have seen ladies that have a leg that's bigger than the other one. Contraceptives can cause that. They can cause women to have hormonal imbalances. Even though they tell you that it balances your hormones, it helps some women, I'm sure, like when it comes to acne and when it comes to weight gain or weight loss. But let's just get to the point. Let's just get to the point of why we are pumping these things in our bodies, not knowing what are in these pills, in these injections, in these patches and IUDs. And why are women only doing this? Why can't men come and meet us halfway? Okay. But a woman can still take control of her body. She can take control of her cycle by learning our bodies and learning our cycles. So we can wean ourselves off these contraceptives and go the natural route. Okay. So we need to have informed consent, you know, to make wise choices when it comes to our bodies. It's about time we take control of our bodies. Do not ask someone, this is happening to me. What do you think it is? You should know what it is, and you should feel your body, and you should know when you're pregnant, like, I am pregnant. I know that I'm pregnant. Why? Because you know your body. And what I found out is that these pills, they can cause like, they compromises who a woman is fundamentally. One example is they disrupt your pheromones. The pheromones are what the hormones that you have, like that helps you when you're trying to find a mate, okay, to make babies. So this is somebody that you'll be attracted to. And what I found out is that women, if maybe they're on contraceptives, Your pheromones are changed somehow, they're disrupted somehow, and then you get attracted to somebody who could be your relative, who could be your sibling. That's what I found out from this documentary by Ricky Lake, The Business of Birth Control. One other thing that I realized is that it changes your libido. I've heard that it changes your libido. It shrinks your clitoris. So what does that make you? So women, I think it's about time we take charge of our bodies and we get to know. So there's an app that I found out about. It's called 28. So this is the app that can help you to track your cycle, that, you know, gives you support as a woman. There's even a tab there whereby it's partner sharing. So you can share to your partner that, okay, this week I'm ovulating, or this week I'm on my period, or, you know, He gets informed as well. He gets to know your body and he knows what's going on. These pills, what I found out is that they're endocrine disruptors. And what is the endocrine system and what does it do? So the endocrine system, produces hormones that help control your mood, your growth, your development, the way your organs work, metabolism, and reproduction. So if we're pumping endocrine disruptors into our bodies, how are all these things going to be taken control of or being taken care of? Okay. And what women get mostly, especially Black women, is polycystic ovary syndrome, which is known as PCOS. It's more common among women of reproductive age, impacting 5 to... So this app is really a game changer. I have left the link in the description box below. Tap on the link, go to the 28 app and see how it can support you in your cycle. It teaches you a cycle. It tells you when you're ovulating. And there's a tab there where you can share this information with your partner so that they know if you're on your period, you're ovulating, you know, so that they also know your body. And remember, in the past, women used to wear like red lipstick or red nail polish to show their partner that it's that time of the month. Well, this app, you just send him an email, and he knows that it's that time of the month. So women, let's take care of our bodies. Let's learn our bodies and our cycles and take control. It's about time. I love you. I love you so much for being here and spending your time with me. Big love always. Mm-hmm.